Good Wednesday morning, Glads. I'm Daniel Robinson.
And I'm Marissa Trujillo, and this is your KWHS News. We hope you're having a great week. Thanks for tuning in. Before we jump into the announcements, let's hear from Miss Betsy for today's lunch menu.
Happy Wednesday, everybody. Today we're having pasta bake, something new on the menu. Come on down and try it out. And then Thursday we're having a hot dog with baked beans, so come on down and see us. Thanks, and have a great day. Bye.
Thanks, Miss Betsy. Students, your free and reduced lunch forms are due today to Miss Betsy. Also remember to add money to your account because you cannot charge your meals.
Glads, buy your yearbooks now for only $55 in the business office. Prices will go up in December. And seniors, listen up. The deadline for baby ads and quotes for the yearbook must be submitted to Miss Kennedy on October 13th or October 20th. October 20th is the last day you can bring those in if you want them in the yearbook. Don't delay. Get those photos and quotes into the yearbook staff or room 104 as soon as possible.
With October just around the corner, those deadlines are coming fast. Marissa, as a senior, how important is it to start your college planning early?
Daniel, it's huge. It's nice to know that so many schools visit us so we can make good choices. Knowing the lineup is helpful, especially for juniors and seniors like you and me.
It sure is. Students, most visits are during advisory in the counseling center and you will need a pass to attend. Here's the lineup for upcoming college visits. October visits start on Tuesday the 3rd with California Baptist University and Colorado Mesa will be here on the 4th. On October 10th, we have two schools scheduled. Fort Hays State University will be here during advisory and Paul Mitchell, the school, will be here at lunch. Hastings College is scheduled to visit on October 12th and CSU Pueblo comes in on October 17th. Pikes Peak Community College will visit on Wednesday, October 18th and rounding out October will be CU Denver on October 31st. November visits start with Luther College on Thursday, November 2nd, while Adams State plans to be here on Thursday, November 16th. Remember to mark your calendars with these dates, and remember to swing by the Counseling Center to pick up your pass to attend.
We are lucky so many schools visit us here to make our college choices easier. Now, here's Kieran Doolittle with our Gladiator Sports Update.
Good Wednesday morning, Glads. I'm Kieran Doolittle, and this is your Gladiator Sports Update. Gladiator athletes are tearing up the fields with all their wins. Here are some scores from last night's action. Our Lady Glads softball team. The ladies are back on home field on Thursday afternoon against Woodland Park at 4 p.m. The boys tennis team took on the Grizzlies on damp Tuesday afternoon and added some additional wins against Mesa to their record. The boys take on the Vanguard School on Thursday afternoon at 3:45 right here at home. In soccer news, the team traveled to Sierra for a game against the Stallions but were unable to steal the win. The boys are on the road on Thursday against Woodland Park at 6 p.m. In volleyball news, the ladies hope to add another W to their scorching record when they play the Elizabeth Cardinals on Thursday night on the road. Mark your calendars for the Lady Glads Dig Pink game on October 3rd. The game is against Mesa Ridge, and the Lady Glads would like to remind everyone to wear pink to the game to raise awareness for breast cancer research. Varsity Cross Country has a meet on Thursday in Canyon City at the Royal Gorge Bridge and Park. Our Gladiator football team is on the road this Friday to take on Chatfield High School at 7 p.m. The Glads are dominating the field. Can they keep it up? And finally, Glads. Open gym for both boys and girls are happening on Mondays and Wednesdays. Pay attention. Here's how they're dividing this time. Ladies start on Monday, October 2nd, in Bowers Gym from 6 to 8 p.m., while the boys will be in the small gym, also on Monday. On Wednesdays, the ladies will be in the small gym and the boys will be in Bowers Gym from 6 to 8 p.m. If you haven't made it to the gym yet, but are interested or need more information, speak with Coach Munoz in room 207. Good luck to all our sports teams this week. That's it for our sports update. Have a great Wednesday. I'm Kieran Doolittle. Now back to you, Daniel and Marissa.
Thanks, Kieran. Attention juniors, if you are interested in taking the PSAT test on Wednesday, October 11th during periods 1 through 4, you need to sign up and pay the fee no later than October 6th. The cost is $16 and Miss Abeda in the Counseling Center will sign you up and collect your fee. The test is optional, but if you are interested in applying for the National Merit Scholar Scholarship, you must take this test. See the Counseling Center website for more information.
Hey Glads, the NJROTC Chocolate Fundraiser is going on right now. If you need a chocolate fix, see any ROTC cadet and they will hook you up with some chocolatey goodness.
Hey Glads, are you getting a good night's sleep? Do you feel like the princess in the pea? It could be your mattress. What to do about it, you ask? WHS Theater Program is holding its first annual mattress fundraiser. You heard that right, it's a mattress sale. On Saturday, October 21st, the WHS Small Gym will have mattresses of all sizes, styles, and price ranges for purchase. You can save up to 50% off retail prices. The sale will run from 10 a.m. to 5 p.m. If you or someone in your family needs a new mattress, you should come check it out. Proceeds benefit the WHS Theater Program.
Finally, here's your club and activities update for Wednesday and Thursday. Student Union is open in the library every day from 3 to 4:15. You must have a sticker on your ID like the one picture to stay and play or to work on homework. For those of you who enjoy tabletop games, that club meets on Wednesdays in room 160 from 3 to 5 p.m. DECA and FBLA meet on Wednesdays at lunch in Lab 159. Link Crew meets during advisory in rooms 123, 124, or 201. On Thursdays, Freshman, Junior, and Senior Councils meet at lunch. Freshman Council meets in room 2. Junior Council meets in room 166, while Senior Council currently meets in room 101. The Pop Orchestra meets in room 750. After school on Thursdays from 3 to 5 p.m. Mr. Nail hosts the Cyber Patriot Club on Thursdays at 3 p.m. in his room. And the Robotics Club meets in room 160 from 3 to 5 on Thursdays.
Remember, the Red Cross Club is collecting pennies for penny wars. Bring your pennies to any English teacher. Pennies count as positive, and any silver coins or dollars count as negative points. Every little bit helps the Red Cross Club fund their causes. Penny Wars runs until the end of the day today. Here are a few more housekeeping notes before we go. But first, a brief reminder about intervention behavior from Mr. Shu.
Hey guys, it's Mr. Shu. Just want to touch base with you because today is an intervention advisory day. You have some choices of where you can go. You're either going to be going to a classroom, the small gym, the library, or the upper commons. Those are your choices. Once you go to those places, it is our expectation that you stay in those places. We will not be roaming the halls. Hope it goes well for you today, guys. Hopefully you're not in my office for not following these rules. Have a great day.
Thanks, Mr. Shoup. Glads, picture retakes are Friday in the small gym from 10 a.m. to noon. If you need to retake your photos, please return your packet, and if you were absent, you should be here for picture retakes on Friday to have your school picture taken.
Students, if you lost or misplaced any personal items at school, check for them in the principal's office at lunch, before or after school. Although they hold items for 2 to 4 weeks, they are cleaning it out, and any items not cleaned by this Friday will be donated.
Well, that's all for us today. Have a great Wednesday. I'm Daniel Robinson.
And I'm Mr. Trujillo, and this was your KWHS News.